good evening, everybody. How's everybody? Thank you. How's everybody doing out there? Welcome to our Fine Arts video premiere event. My name is Ringo, and I'm the extremely proud director of Fine Arts for Goose Creek CISD. We cannot wait to feature our students today in a very, very, very special way. I know we had some dramatic superhero music before we played because our kids are superheroes. They're nothing less than that. So is our staff. They do phenomenal things, and we can't wait to share that with you. But you did not come up here to hear me talk. So are we ready to start the show?
Yep.
You ready? Okay. Without any further ado, let me introduce the Sterling Stars officers.
Tell me something good. Are you happy in this moment? Or do you need more? Is there something that you're searching for? In all the good times I find myself longing.
Because I'm one of four boys, and you can imagine my mother trying to raise four boys. We were kind of rowdy and rambunctious, and mostly fighting to get to the dinner table first. But she knew early on in our childhood that we would need to be taught a little culture in class in life. And Candlelight Park was the first time I learned to water paint, to finger paint, to play with clay, and mold things from clay. I learned how to oil paint at Candlelight Park in the neighborhood. My mother would pay for each of us four boys to go and be trained in music. We learned how to play the piano. The piano was not quite enough. We still were not cultured enough, so we learned how to play the accordion. And from the accordion, I moved on into junior high and learned how to play the trombone. But my origin with fine arts was from my youngest days as a child. And I remember my mother working two jobs, and my father working as well, just to ensure that we had that enrichment, so that we would not be simple-minded, headed just towards one thing, which ultimately ended up being athletics. And each of us were four-sport athletes and what have you, but if it hadn't been for my childhood, my mother's focus on each one of us four boys having a fine arts upbringing and a broad perspective, I wouldn't be the man that I am today. So when I am here serving as your superintendent of schools, saying how proud I am to be the superintendent of Goose Creek, I could not be more proud of the fine arts programs that we have in pre-K through 12th grade and beyond, I will say. And you're just going to get a little snippet of what we have to offer our students while they're in school. Not that you would pay for them outside of school, but that it's here, offered within the school system here in Goose Creek. And I could not be more proud of that. I know many of you participate in extracurricular activities outside of the school, but just want to give a big shout out to Mr. Levan as our director, and each and every single director on every single campus that promotes fine arts, so that our children can truly be developed fully. Our mission to develop the whole child is sincere. We seek to let every child pursue whatever their interest might be, and we think that fine arts will broaden that horizon just a little bit more. So thank you all for coming out tonight to see a little snippet of what our kids are able to do. Thank you.
Will be the Lee High School Percussion Ensemble under the direction of Dr. Stephen Ice.
Thank you. turning their page to play the next piece called Surfside. This is the product of 2 weeks of being on these instruments. These are brand new to our school. We are thrilled to have them. This is all part of the bond that passed a few years back. So we are thrilled to have these instruments. They came in literally 2 weeks ago, and this is the product of basically about 4 or 5 rehearsals. So we are thrilled to present them to you. Surfside. Got it all?
Thank you.
to speak about what the fine arts programs have done for them and how it affects their lives and how it affects their education. So first, we have the award-winning actress, and Robert, yeah, go ahead. That's what we're here for, celebrate. The award-winning actress and Robert D. Lee celebrity, senior Miss McKinley Ray.
What has theater done for you? I honestly couldn't answer because that's who I am. The art, the performance, the training, that is me. But I truly didn't see the question at the time. How did theater make me? Through this artwork, I have been able to read very fluently. I've been able to realize greater than just the words. However, the literature in the back of any textual content, the emotion at the back of any text, and most importantly, the meaning in any text. I've been able to articulate and enunciate properly. In other words, I talk good. Back in my day, as you more experienced people would say, I have had the honor and the privilege of being taught by the one and only Rosemary Calico Hobson. When you're a child, your parents teach you to ask for what you want. And then as you become older, it would be more specific. What do you want? Well, if anyone has taught me that, it was that lady. When I was 4 years old, I stepped foot on the stage for the first time. I looked up at that lady and said, I want to act. So therefore, I nailed my first role as a bunny in Snow White. The best bunny. My request from I want to act turned into I want to be lead, to getting my first lead role as Tinkerbell and Peter Pan. Mind you, both of these roles did not have speaking parts. So my last and final requests were, I want the lead speaking part. And there it was. There I was. The one and only Henny Penny. Yeah, I know. Ask and you shall receive, says the Lord. Yeah, well, so did she. To my current director, Ms. Henderson, who has implemented the importance of humbleness, and most importantly, that I can never stop learning. I can never stop trying to improve, tweaking my character, finding the truth, finding the reality. I can never stop digging into the skin of what I love. And for that, I walk into my future, never stopping. Thank you.
For our next testimonial, we have senior band president from Ross S. Sterling High School, Mr. Riley Benoit.
Hello, my name is Riley Benoit, and I am the band president of the Ross S. Sterling High School Band. It is quite the honor to stand before you all here tonight to share a few thoughts about what the Fine Arts Program has done for me over my time as a student at Goose Creek. Being involved in fine arts since kindergarten in Ms. Carol Colvin's music class inspired me to pursue music in some form or fashion. Ms. Collins here tonight. When it was time to choose my electives for junior high, I chose band because I really wanted to play the trombone. Once I got to high school, I became part of the massive family that is the Sterling Silver Spectacular Band. Not only did I learn so much about music, but I learned many life lessons, leadership skills, and other skills that will come in handy as I enter the professional world. Having a program as strong as the Sterling Band and the Greater Goose Creek Fine Arts Program is something that not every kid gets to experience, and I am incredibly thankful that our district has enabled fine arts students to pursue their dreams. I'm so thankful for leaders like Mr. Levan, Dr. O'Brien, Dr. McCall, and many others who have always been so supportive of the Fine Arts Program. And I think seeing this video tonight will help us all appreciate a little more how important it is to showcase the many talents that our Goose Creek Giants have. Thank you all for your time.
And our final student testimonial is a very special one. Not only is this young lady a senior from Lee High School, not only is she another Robert E. Lee celebrity doing double duty, not only is she an award-winning visual artist, but if you look at your playbills, if you see the new Fine Arts logo that you see directly in front of you, this young lady won a district-wide art contest to be the official Fine Arts logo moving forward. This young lady designed the logo that you see in front of you. And in fact, she rose above over 100 other competitors to win this contest. And in fact, not only does she have a starring role in a project that you'll see later, not only will she stand before you now, But she also, through the help of our partners in education at ExxonMobil, received a MacBook Air as first prize for this contest. So without any further ado, Miss Courtney Childs.
That made a person go wow. My main inspiration was from a scene in Disney's The Little Mermaid, when she was on the rock with the waves crashing down as she was singing her ending note in Part of Your World. That feeling of wow I got from that scene was what I wanted viewers to feel whenever they saw my logo design. I created that feeling of waves crashing down using gold paint splatter around the dancer. The reason I used the dancer as the main focus was to create a symbol for the students who are multifaceted in all of the arts like me. Not only am I an artist, I am a dancer, and I am a performer at heart. I hope that my logo is able to inspire the next generation of young, talented performers to be able to express themselves within the fine arts. Thank you for this amazing opportunity, and y'all have a good night.
All right, our next student performance will be from the incomparable Robert E. Lee Jazz Band under the direction of Mr. Robert Poulin. Give him a couple seconds to get set up and we'll be ready to go.
Thank you. about one more from Duke Ellington, a piece called Caravan. On you.
so much, guys. Wasn't that great?
Jazzy!
Yes, it was in fact jazzy. So we have a treat for you this evening. We have a surprise guest that could make it out this evening. The video project that we're about to explore in a minute was very much a collaborative effort. And I'd like to introduce, we'd like to come out and say a few words, the writer and fellow producer of this video project. He's worked for the district for many, many times. He's also a Goose Creek alumni. It's my pleasure to introduce Mr. Rick King.
Good evening. I am a product of Travis and Baytown Jr. and Robert E. Lee, and I've always had a love of the fine arts. I don't even really understand, I'm not sure even when I knew that I did, I just always did. I was singing jingles for commercials when I was 2 or 3. But Mr. LeVan had a vision that he wanted us to bring alive, which was, a lot of kids don't understand that fine arts is an option. They don't even know what it means or what's out there or what opportunities there are. And so we brainstormed with him, and we came up with this concept. He had a concept, and then we kind of just gave it life and let it grow. But the concept became that we were going to turn this actual auditorium into a magical box. And we filmed for 2 days inside this magical box. And inside this magical box was going to be everything that fine arts can be. And we were going to give it a life in the visual arts and film, whether it was lyrical dancing or hip-hop or steel drums or jazz or orchestra or marching band or cheer, art, sculpting, whatever it could be, we were going to give it all a life in this box. And I don't know if you've seen the film Birdman, but we decided that we really wanted to film it in a POV, point of view, linear style. So we would bring you into this theater and walk you through the theater and show you all these arts at very close range, just a few feet away. And it's almost as if you're walking and seeing the entire district. All of Goose Creek is encapsulated in this one magical box. And it was a pure joy to work with all those talented kids and be that close to them. And get to go from kids who can play the trumpet, to these great dancers, to these artists, the digital artists, and the painters, and the sculptors, and the drawing illustrators. It was just a lot of energy and joy to be around that talent. So I hope you like the video, and I hope it achieves its goal, which is to open up the eyes of young students and let them understand how much fine arts can be a food for the soul and a calling, and just something that really inspires and nurtures and gives us all a lot of joy in our lives. Thank you.
So what Mr. King elaborated on is something we like to call the arts effect. What you feel whenever you heard the steel band, or whenever you reacted emotionally to the dancers earlier, or when your head was nodding and your foot was tapping to the jazz band, that's the arts effect. In fact, that's a hashtag for our department, the arts effect. Because in the body of education, the fine arts is its soul. It encompasses all disciplines and subjects. It teaches our students love, compassion, understanding, and teamwork. It allows our students to express themselves in its purest form, even when words will not suffice for how they feel. The Goose Creek Fine Arts Department can be summed up into a simple sentence: excellence in artistry. What that means is that our fine arts programs and educators come every day to demonstrate the three A's that our program is built on, which are artistry, academics, and achievement. Our levels of artistry are evident in the multitudes of options for our students across all grade levels, from our new pre-K STEAM Academy, STEAM, and that A stands for arts, Academy, we take our students from the humblest beginnings and make sure that the winds are right for them to soar. Music, dance, theater, visual arts, all four disciplines offer something for everyone to tap into, because every single Goose Creek student is a fine arts student. Every single one. Academically, it is very easy to see what the arts effect does, as national studies show profound effect that the arts has on intelligence and other areas of brain function. Fine arts students perform better in the classroom. Plain and simple. End of discussion. A simple example would be a quick survey of the top 10 of every high school graduating class. I would wager that at least 5 of them are fine arts students. Our programs achieve through a strong tradition of excellence. All of our programs routinely produce sweepstakes, performances, superior ratings, and individual accolades for our students, including regional, area, state, and even national recognitions. We continue to innovate and strive to be at the forefront of fine arts education. We as a staff strive for one goal: to give our students a world-class fine arts education while being the very best fine arts department, not just in the state of Texas, but in the nation. Our students serve as role models of what can happen when hard work and talent collide. Our staff exemplify that hard work and dedication because they do not just teach, but they reach our students in meaningful ways that will last a lifetime. This project that we're about to see is just a glimpse of what it is that we do. This was a true labor of love and a collaborative effort, as we said before. Its very existence shows the power of the arts effect. This video is a product of 5 months of work, coordinated with 8 campuses, 20 student groups, and 5 different departments. That's a lot, isn't it? So are you ready to see it?
Yeah.
Okay. And without any further ado, this is what excellence in artistry looks like. This is the Arts Effect.
Don't want to lay with her, though.
I'm old-fashioned that way. You knew I was old-fashioned when you married me. We're going to decide this today.
Let's do this tomorrow.
I'm not leaving without knowing where I'm going to be staying for the next 200 years. You'll book a shopping mall here, on our bones, I imagine.
That's fantastic.
my gosh, did you see the crowd?
Yeah, it's packed.
I can't wait to go out there.
This is gonna be so amazing.
Showtime, ladies!
Let's go,
girl. Beautiful, beautiful. Yes, yes, you too. Let's go.
Oh, save it for the scene. Cue fog, sequence on four.
Fog ready? Three, two.
Cue dream lights.
It was so awesome!
Yeah? What was your favorite part?
All of it.
That's the horse. Contributed to this in one way or another, all the student groups that were involved in the filming. In fact, do we have any students in the house that were actually in the video? Could you stand and be recognized? Yeah. Also, do we have any staff, any fine arts staff in the building? Can you stand and be recognized, please? Thank you all so much. We'd like to also thank our Board of Trustees. Without their support, this never could have happened. Also, we'd like to thank you for, number one, loaning us your children. I know he wants to keep them, but we got to give them back. Also, for passing the bond, so allowing all of these wonderful programs, this wonderful building that we filmed in and that you're experiencing right now, all of these great steel drums that you see, and a lot of this brand new auditorium was all
by way of the bond. So we thank you so very much for your support. I'd like to publicly thank Dr. O'Brien, my boss. And I'd like to also thank my direct boss, Dr. Demetrius McCall. I don't know if he's here this evening, but thank you so much for your support. Be done without you guys. So moving forward, what does this mean? How is this going to be used? This is going to show, without a shadow of a doubt, not only how serious our commitment to the arts is, but all of the options that we have and to gain interest. So we're going to move forward from here because we're just going to keep getting better. We're going to keep innovating, be the tip of the spear, and our staff, we have a goal. We say our goal is world domination. It's a joke, but we mean it too. Yes. Oh, by the way, I'd like to publicly thank Holly Willem. Thank you for letting me steal that. I appreciate that. So, thank you so much for coming out this evening. We appreciate you so very much. And not to mention, parents, give yourselves a hand. Thank you so very much. We appreciate you coming out this evening. And we look forward to seeing you again in the future. Thank you so much. Have a great evening.